5 years after the Viking villagers of Burk and the dragons made peace, they lived together in harmony. Hiccup and his dragon, Toothless, discover and map unexplored lands. Now, 20 years old, he is being pressured by his father, Stoic the Vast, to succeed him as chieftain, although Hiccup feels unsure he is ready. While investigating a burnt forest, Hiccup and Astrid discover the remains of a fort encased in ice and meet a group of dragon trappers led by Erit, who blames the two for his fort's destruction and attempts to capture their dragons for the conqueror, Drago Bloodvist. Hiccup and Astrid escape and warn Stoic about the dragon army Drago is creating. Stoic orders the villagers to fortify the island and prepare for battle. Hiccup, however, refuses to believe war is inevitable and flies off to talk to Drago. Stoic stops him, explaining that he once met Drago at a gathering of chiefs, where Drago had offered to protect them from dragons if they pledged to serve him. When they refused, he had his dragons attack them, with Stoic the sole survivor. Undeterred, Hiccup flies off with Toothless in search of Drago to try to reason with him. They meet a dragon rider named Valka, who is revealed to be Hiccup's long-lost mother. She explains that she, like her son, could not bring herself to kill dragons. After being carried off during a dragon raid, she spent 20 years rescuing dragons from Drago's traps and bringing them to an island nest created out of ice by a gigantic alpha dragon called a Bewilderbeast, which is able to control smaller dragons. Stoic and his lieutenant Gobber track Hiccup to the nest, where Stoic discovers his wife is alive. Meanwhile, Astrid and the other riders force Erit to lead them to Drago. Drago captures them, and upon learning of Burk's dragons, sends his armada over to the dragon nest to attack, while the riders escape with Erit's help. At the nest, a battle ensues between the dragon riders, Valka's dragons, and Drago and his armada, during which Drago reveals he has his own Bewilderbeast to challenge the alpha. The two colossal dragons fight, ending with Drago's Bewilderbeast killing its opponent and becoming the new alpha. Drago's Bewilderbeast seizes control of all the adult dragons, which hypnotically obey. Hiccup tries to persuade Drago to end the violence, but Drago orders him to be killed. Toothless, under the Bewilderbeast's influence, approaches Hiccup and launches a plasma bolt toward him, but Stoic pushes Hiccup away and is killed instead. The Bewilderbeast momentarily relinquishes control of Toothless, but Hiccup drives Toothless away in a fit of despair. Drago maroons Hiccup and the others on the island, and rides Toothless, again under the control of the Bewilderbeast, to lead his army to conquer Burk. Stoic is given a Viking funeral, and Hiccup, now having lost both his father and dragon, is unsure what to do. Valka encouragingly tells him he alone can unite humans and dragons. Inspired by her words and his father's, Hiccup returns to Burk to stop Drago. The dragon riders fly baby dragons, immune to the Bewilderbeast's control, back to Burk. They find Drago has attacked the village and taken control of its dragons. Hiccup confronts Drago and a brainwashed Toothless while the other riders distract the Bewilderbeast. Hiccup frees Toothless from the Bewilderbeast's control, much to Drago's surprise. Hiccup and Toothless briefly separate Drago from the Bewilderbeast and confront Drago on the ground, but the Bewilderbeast attacks them, encasing them in ice. However, Toothless blasts away the ice, revealing that both Hiccup and he are unharmed. Toothless then challenges the Bewilderbeast, shooting it in the face repeatedly, which breaks its control over the other dragons, who side with Toothless as the new alpha. All the dragons repeatedly fire at the Bewilderbeast until Toothless fires a final massive blast, breaking its left tusk. Defeated, the Bewilderbeast retreats under the sea with Drago on its back. The Vikings and dragons celebrate their victory and Hiccup is made chieftain of Burk. Afterwards, Burk undergoes repairs, with Hiccup feeling secure that its dragons can defend it.